My name is Amber Kelly. I am the owner of Things Other Things, and today I'm going to talk about the Afghan loom and the Afghan KB, the KB Afghan loom and the S loom. Kind of like what's the difference in them. I have not used my KB loom, Afghan loom yet, but I do plan on using that. I have used my S loom, and I have made a baby blanket out of it. So I'm just going to start with the differences. So this is the KB Afghan loom. And I wrote down some notes because I'm very forgetful. So yes, this is the KB Afghan loom. It's not as hard as people say it is. It's really not. But it does have a lot more pegs. To me, it's smaller than the S loom. And I'll show you the difference between the S loom and the Afghan loom. This is the Afghan loom, the KB. This is the S loom. So you can see the difference. This one is longer. This one is green. This one is shorter, but it has way more pegs. This one has 198 pegs. With this one, it's 60 inches wide. So yes, it's 60 inches wide. It has 198 pegs. Yes, you can. Yes, you can remove the pegs. You may have to work with it a little bit to remove the pegs. I have not removed the pegs yet, because I don't feel like I have a need to remove them. And then I'm just scared to remove them just because. But yes, they are removable. You can make a twin Afghan with this. You can even use the Lion's Brands yarn with this one. Because how small the Lion's Brand yarn is, you may need 12 skeins. You can use acrylic yarn with this. When you go over 12, you're going to get a nice, good size blanket with this one. It's about 1 1/4 inch in space in between the pegs. This one you can get it at Joann's for $34.99. You can get it on Amazon for $32.33. If you get it at Joann's, there is a coupon, just like they always have coupons. So you can get you can use a coupon on this one. I mean, I like it. Just because to me it's right here in my face, so it's not like I have to go all the way down here, as opposed to this one. You can see it's how much longer it is. So with the S loom, and this one, the S loom, you can get this one from the green one. You can get this one from Michaels, and this one has 148 pegs. You can use medium to bulky yarn, and you can get this one from Michaels for $24.99. Now, like I said, I have done a baby blanket with this one. What I will say is that when you do use this one, it's going to be kind of hard for you to get your yarn to go through here. So as you go, you're going to have to pull on it. And you see how I could just flip, that is like flimsy. On the other side, I do like it because it has like more space in between. So I can put my whole finger in between here. With this one, I will warn you, it's going to take you some time. This is not one of those projects that you can be done in like 15 minutes. I have seen people take up to a year to finish a blanket with this one. Just because you can't get bored with this. You can't get bored with this. But it's always good to have something like this going and like another project going, like a round loom project going. When I did the baby blanket on this one, it did not take me as long. Just because, like I said, again, the spaces in between the pegs are wider. And as you can see, the spaces on here are closer together. So when the pegs are closer together, it's going to take you longer to get done. But like I said, for the most part, I like this one just because this one is much more sturdier. Like I said, this one was made by KB, www.knittingboard.com. And if you get that orange hook, that is also good to use. Me, I do not recommend that you use the hooks that come with your loom sets just because they do cause bruises. I have had blisters on my hands. I have had bruises on my hands because I was using those little picks. Like I said, I do recommend that you use the orange KB hook. And like I said, you just visit their site. Love, love, love. They have a ton of free patterns. So if you're looking for patterns to go on here, on this one, just go to www.knittingboard.com. But like I said, I do like this one. I have not even used it yet, and I like it. I do plan on using it really soon. Again, with this one, I have not used it since I made that blanket. I would not recommend that you try to do like a king size type of blanket with this. You can get away with a baby blanket. That is all I recommend for this one, just because this cannot take a whole lot. This is plastic. This is that flimsy plastic, and you see how easy I can move this? Like, when you're doing, like, if you're going to do a king-size, full-size blanket, that would not be good for this one. I recommend that if you're going to do a king-size or a nice-size throw, use this one. Now, it may take you longer, but your loom will not break. If you try to do it on here, it will probably break and you're going to be mad. So, that's my take on the Afghan NK, the KB Afghan loom and the S loom. In other words, they call it the Infinity loom. But so, like I said, that's my take on it. See you later. Bye. And please subscribe. Bye.